this is Stampy, and welcome back to my Let's Play on The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. So my plan for today is to go into this giant cube, which is out there on the water. It's one of the labyrinths, and looking at the map, you can see it's on this level, it's in the Sky Island, and we can only assume it is going to be down in the depths as well. There's not a clear and obvious way to reach it, to be fair. Maybe I should just build like a little hot air balloony thing. Oh, there's some stuff lying around down here. Yeah, so this looks like it's to make a sailboat. But I might repurpose this and make a hot air balloony thing on it and fly up that way. Right, what do we have? How many of the hot air balloony things do we have? Okay, we've got 22 of them. And then I guess we'll do a fan because we want to go forward. I won't do too many because I want to go up more than forward because worst case I can just glide down. Anything else? Oh, and I guess I'll just use a... Oh, no, not a frost emitter. Not a frost emitter. I guess I'll just use a flame emitter. Oh, no. Let's get rid of the... How do I get rid of... I'm trying to decrease. There we go. Okay, we got it. Is that it? Is that all we need? That's kind of all we need really, isn't it? Right, so let's make this. Oh, and I did. Did I still do the frost emitter? Right, is this the flame one? Oh, I'm going to have to find out which is which. I thought I got rid of it. That is frost. Oh, this one better be fire. Oh, no, I'm going to set fire to my thing. No! Throw it in the water. In the water. Quick. Quick. Oh, oh dear. That nearly ended badly. Maybe building this out of wood was a... was a bad idea. Luckily, I had pretty quick reactions to get that in there. Right. I don't know if I'm making this too big for what I need, but I think this should work. Like, really, we kind of could just go up and not worry about the fan. And people always tell me off for building these things wrong, because I'm meant to put the flame emitter in that little basket would make sense. But, you know, it doesn't matter. Like, there's someone who, like, commented saying, like, oh, it really infuriates me that every time they get it wrong. It's like, well, every time I do it, it works. So, like, who's to say what's wrong or right? Is that working? Yes, it is. Oh, okay, is it actually working? Yes, it is. Okay, that would have been really bad if that just launched me off the edge there. Yeah, I see how that probably should go in the balloon, but this makes sense. And, oh, it's actually working. Pretty well. I think the only thing is the fan is blowing me forward too much. I tell you what, let's just ditch the fan. We've got a bit of forward momentum anyway. And, oh, I think I might have a little bit too much. Oh, I might actually be able just to ascend through that. Oh, no, this is perfect. Oh, my God, look. This is... Oh, look how perfect this is. I almost don't need to jump. I could almost just have, like, walked off the edge because of how well that was done. Oh, pat on the back for me. Oh, where's the shrine? Oh... I thought that shrine was just out in the open, it looked like, for the ground, but it looks like it's tucked away, and we have a diary here. Research log, day one. It took us 2 days to reach this isolated island. Though the ruin stood before us, we were too exhausted to explore. Though weary, Toro was able to decipher the Zonai writing on the stone slab. The dragon ring slumbers in the labyrinth's depths. Wake it, and ye shall receive due compensation. While his translation provided me with renewed vigour, Toro shortly thereafter fell ill with fatigue. After seeing him off on his way home, I swore to tackle the ruins myself. The acorns and nuts I have prepared to mark my path should see to it that I do not get lost inside. Though I am alone, I need to work hard enough for both Toro and myself. Acorns and nuts, eh? Ah! Acorn. Oh, this is like deep water here. Okay. Acorn. Right, which way do we go now? Oh. Nut. Oh. Acorn. I feel like we're going around in circles. Oh, dear. So, yeah, I guess we'll just go for a wander. Let's look on the map and see, like, what's... If there's any... Ah, so there's, like, a thing, like a black speck. Around the corner there. Let's go and check that out in case that's something useful. Okay, looks like that's just like loot that I can gather on the way through. So it looks like we're probably trying to get to there, right? So it looks like... Oh, is that where we're... Oh, unless we're trying to get to there? So what would be the way? That would link me up to... Maybe if I go down here. So down here. And then... I can't actually see a way that is linking up to where I am. You know what? I probably should have just stayed on my hot air balloon and just flown over this whole area to get to the middle. I've done it in the past and I'm not proud of it. But I guess then I would lose out on all of the loot I get on the inside. So you know what? Rather than working this out properly or following the chestnuts or whatever, I might just go for a wander and see what I can find around here. Ah, what's this? Okay, I found a thing. I found a cube. Ah, is this just hiding a chest on the other side of it? Those like... Oh, I'm on the other side of the chest I got earlier. Oh, this will give me a large zone I charge. Not too bad. Yeah, so those nuts and chestnuts just seem to be like absolutely all over the place. So like directly following them doesn't seem to be like a plan, because it seems like this person went absolutely all over the place. I've put on my armor to allow me to swim faster, because there's quite a lot of water in here as well. So right, let me keep up with my random wanderings. I can always use the shrine thing as well to make sure I'm heading in the direction of the shrine, which might end up coming in useful. But like from looking at the map from above, it didn't seem like there was an obvious route that would link to here. Like, because look, it's a dead end to there. Then if I went this way, it would lead round to here, which is then a dead end. So I'm assuming there's a bit where I'm going to have to go, like, through the wall or under it or something. Right, looks like we're back on the trail of acorns and stuff. So let's just follow these this way for a bit and see if this leads to anything good. Oh, I found another one of the diaries. Oh, day two. Looks like I'm on the right track then. I walk carefully, avoiding the stirring gloom. Just one touch and it will invade my body in the blink of an eye. It was a wise decision to send Toro home. Allowing him to continue our trek in his condition may have proved fatal. But what exactly is this strange gloom? More importantly, have they found the princess and her swordsman who delved beneath Hyrule Castle to investigate it? I can only pray for their safety. I'm good, mate. It's fine. Don't worry about it. I mean, Zelda... Who knows? Actually, she's just having a tea party with her mates back in time. So she's fine. and I am doing good, but I'm lost. So this is actually leading me right to the middle. Oh, and then there's a ladder. Ah, this is what I wanted. A way to get inside. Have I just done it? I do believe I may have just done it. And ah, so there's some like stuff here that I could probably burn away. I wonder if I'm going to come back down this way from the other side. But you know what? While I'm under here, I could always ascend through this to get up to the top up there. But I'm guessing I probably can't climb this wall here. Oh, wait. Oh, can I? I can climb the wall. Wait, can I have just climbed any of these walls to get up to the top? Oh, well, this is just to get some loot. A strong zonite longsword that I don't have room for, typically. You know, I got two of these cannon things. Let's just get rid of that. I'm never really using that anyway. There we go. Oh, a strong zonite. So it doesn't look that great for now, but I haven't fused anything to it. But if I could, I would get a good upgrade. Right then, we do seem to be on the right track, though. We are still getting the nuts and acorns, and we are in that middle area. It's just, is that shrine going to be blocked off? Or am I going to be able to get straight to it from here? It's looking pretty promising, although I got a bit too enthusiastic and ran out. And oh, we're here. Is the shrine here? The shrine is here. We've got another diary entry. Research log day 3. My searching has finally led me to a Zonai relic. I must hurry back and tell Toro about it. Though I must admit, my curiosity remains piqued. I'm not sure if I'm quite ready to leave these ruins. For instance, I can see a lower level from this room. Just how is one supposed to reach it? Well, let's press the button. And let's see what the button will do. Will this allow us to go to, like, one of the other labyrinths? For you who conquered this labyrinth of the land, I, the ruler of dragons, have unlocked a door. Find it on the south side of the labyrinth in the sky. Okay, so it looks like we're going sky next. And oh, then we're probably going to dive all the way from the top down into the depths as well afterwards. Right then, let's go do this this shrine, though. I wonder if it's going to be a proper shrine or a Raru's Blessing shrine. Either way, I get good loot. Oh, it's just a Raru's Blessing one. At least we won't be wasting any time before getting back to our labyrinth quest. So I got to work out how to get up to the one in the sky. I mean, I could just build a thing that just flies straight up. But I wonder if there's any other sky islands or like a tower or any way that I could get up quicker. Let's just have a look at the area and the map once I get out of here. Okay then, let's have a look around then. Seeing as this is all open up, I could get back here, I guess, pretty easy. Let's ascend up here. And then we'll look up as high as we can and see if there's an easy route for me to be able to get up there. It seems pretty isolated, you know. I mean, there are a few little islands around here, but there's no obvious way to get to them. I mean, I could go to here, the water temple, and then maybe fly to these and then make my way to the labyrinth from them. Have I been on these? Oh, so how do I get it so I only see the ones on the sky islands? Ah, so are these only sky islands? No, that's the ground. There we go. Ah, so I've been on this thing. I guess I fought a boss there, but I've not actually been to any of these sky islands. So let's try and be efficient then. Let's go to here, and then we can try and fly to these sky islands. Let's complete these on the way, and then make our way to the labyrinth, because the temples are often like really, really high up. And so then I could only need to like glide horizontally in order to reach where I need to go. Right, okay, so I've marked a pin, and I need to go straight in that direction from here. So I guess I'll do a glider device. Actually, I might be able to just auto build one. So there might be a pretty good one that I got from one of those. Yeah, I mean, there's that fan plane there, but it doesn't have a steering stick. But you know what? I might not actually need one. So let's just make this. It's got three fans, because that's what I want. And oh, does it have... okay, so I'm going to have to launch it manually because there's no cart. So my way I do this is I just go out and up like that to get it as high and far away as possible. Then I bring it back and recall it. And then I'm high enough in the sky that if I just set this going, I should be able to reach where I need to go. So yeah, as I said, it's the blue marker is where I was heading to. So it looks like there's stuff over... Oh yeah, let's just wait until we're out of this area. Because it keeps trying to show... Actually, I can do this, can't I? So which... Oh, is it quite low down? Oh, is it down underneath me there? Because there's a bunch that are... And I think that's the labyrinth right there. Ah, so tell you what, let's head to the Sky Islands that are over here. Because I'm more... Actually, you know what? I don't know if I would reach them, you know? Yeah, look, those Sky Islands, I'm like... almost right above them, but they're really like low down. But you know what, I might as well do them and then fly from them there. So yeah, let's drop down onto that big sphere. We'll do that first, and from there we could probably fly to those other skies. Oh, actually there is a boosty thing down there, because you know this glider is going to start disappearing soon anyway. I don't think I'd even be able to reach to those islands. So let's set down maybe there, because that seems to be the highest one of this group of sky islands that we have down here. And you know what, we're gonna run out of energy soon now anyway, so let's commit. And there we go, there's the glider about to disappear. I'm glad I did it this way. Right, what do we have here? Looks like there's nothing. Is there anything hidden in there? No, it's just like an island full of like a bunch of gliders around here. Then there's that big cube there. Okay, maybe we'll use one of these gliders. I can just grab one of these fans to put it on the back. I just wanted to make sure there's no loot or anything special up here, but it doesn't seem like there is. There's probably a shrine in that big sphere. I swear I've been in one of those before. I can't remember exactly how I did it. And there's definitely a shrine on that island to the right, but it's one of the ones where I got to get the crystal. Oh, hopefully there wasn't a crystal on that island I've just left and would need to go back. But you know, if there is... You know what could be really smart? I could fly this here, and then I could recall it in order to get back there. That would be really smart. So if I do need to return to where I am, I could always do that. Right, let's turn this fan off. Oh no, let's turn the fan back on. Okay, turned it off a little bit too early. Right, now let's turn the fan off, and we can go for an elegant landing into that staircase. All right, so if we activate this, it will show us where the crystal is that we need to retrieve. And as I said, if it is back to where we just been, we can recall it. I'm really kind of hoping that it is there and I just missed it on that island. Because that would be a really satisfying way just to get back up there and skip the way I was actually meant to do it. Right, where's the crystal? Oh, it could be pointing there. Or is it pointing into the... Ooh. Is it either pointing into the big sphere or to something behind it? I kind of wish it showed up on the way. Let me maybe go down this side and look at it from side on. And then I can see her side on. Do you get it? then I can see whether the laser comes out of the other side. Ooh, dazzle fruit. I always like those. And a zonai charge. And no, look, it's just going into that giant sphere. Okay, looks like we need to go and get inside of there. I think there was an opening on the top of it. We might just be able to use that to launch us in order for us to get into it. Or I could actually maybe recall the glider and then drop off when I'm in the air. That could also work as well. All right, let's do this though, because I've not done this capsule device, so there's a good chance I may get something that I've never used before. Oh, we're getting more of the stakes. That's good. Oh, and the homing carts. And cannons. Oh, and that. Oh, this is an amazing one. This one, honestly, this one's probably my best one I've been to yet. And there's something, because that's all of this stuff is really useful things that, like, I don't seem to normally be getting many of. Oh, no, I didn't mean to use that. Oh, dear. I meant to hold it. Oh, well, I've got a few of them. It's all right. I got a bunch of zonite to make more as well. And there's also something. If the other thing in here is good, then this is, like, proper S-tier capsule device. And, oh, okay, looks like the other thing is carts, which is fine. Which is fine. It is something that I do use. But that is still absolutely amazing. Right, if I recall this, let me set to recall from here and let me see the path it's going to go. Yeah, you know what? This actually might work pretty well. If I recall, I'm going to go right over that sphere. Oh, if I can go steady. So let's jump off when I'm right at the peak here. And no, actually, is the open? Oh, and the opening's right there. Oh, this is amazing. This is amazing. So now I can just jump off and go straight into here. That was such a satisfying way to solve that puzzle. but we're not done yet, are we? So there's a launcher thing set up there. So this is going to spin like everything, right? Oh, but it looks like there is a little... There's a bit underneath down there with a chest in it. And I'm curious about what's in there. So let's for now just turn this round. Then I could launch the crystal out. And then I also have got to find out how to get... Is there an opening underneath the sphere? How would I get underneath there? Like, when I spin this, would that in any way set up an... Because I can only turn this... Like, in, like, a circle like that. I can't really move it up or down or do anything else. But there's got to be a way to get that chest. Taylor, let's just worry about this crystal for now. And then maybe we'll worry about the chest after that. It's kind of confusing turning it. I think it needs to be facing there. But then maybe a little bit like that. And then where's the crystal? So I guess if I could just launch the crystal and then I'll just go after. Well, I'll launch the crystal with me, but I don't want to attach it because otherwise it's not going to go anywhere. So let's just set that there. Then I need to clamber on this thankfully already built contraption to save me some time. And then, whoa, okay. Oh, where'd the crystal go? Ooh, is it good? Are we good? Are we good? I think we're good. And actually now that opening's on that side, I could always use this to launch me back to the other side. Oh, no, where's the crystal? Oh, I guess I could follow the laser. Oh, it's just pointing. Oh, has it reset? I think it might have reset. Maybe it fell off. I need to be quick because I could try and like grab it in the air or something if I can in order to get it back. But it looks like it's just returned to here. Let's give that a go because that almost worked perfectly. I guess what I could do is I could attach this to something that's like less bouncy or something to weigh it down. But I think I should be able to get this to work. Let's just give it another shot and hope it works because it is quite fun to do anyway. God, I tell you, it's not the easiest thing for me to get back onto. And oh, wait, all the springs are still up. There we go. That's why I was struggling so much to get on it this time. Then if I run around here, I guess I could climb over that way. Right, if I do this, if I then get Ultra Hand. Oh, I can't use Ultra Hand when I'm midair. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. No! Oh no, this is a disaster actually, because I can't teleport back. Oh no, I think I can go back up there, you know. Actually, I'm not going to just do it from here because I did activate that. Oh, that's so lucky. I thought I was going to have to go the whole way back up there again. I think the crystal's probably reset. I think I just need to aim it slightly to the right is all I need to do. Oh, it's reset the whole thing again. Look, it's put the opening back to that other side again. That's annoying. I do need to investigate if there is an opening on the underneath of it. If I'll then be able to, like, ascend up through it somehow in order to get that chest. Because otherwise, I still have absolutely no idea how I'll do that. Anyway, let's just try and line this up a little bit better than I had been doing it before. Why isn't it turning? Wait, do I have to move? It's so confusing to know how this is going to work. Right, so it's nearly at this. As long as I line it up with that opening perfectly, we should be, Oh, look, it's so confusing how to know how to turn. Like I'm holding to the right and it's not turning. Do I have to, like, move to the right and then turn it? Or go to the left? Why do I not understand how to do this thing? Okay, there we go. That looks like that's lined up okay now. Let's grab the crystal again. And I'm just going to be quick to try and ultra hand it. If it looks like it's going off wild again. If I can get on top of this thing. Okay, right. Off you go. Oh my god! Okay, well, I guess I could wait for a second and see if the crystal reappears here. Because if it does, I know the crystal's gone. Okay. Oh no! I got my hopes up that it was working then. Oh, that's a shame. Right, maybe I'm gonna have to adjust the position a little bit more. It'd be good if I could launch it so it goes, like, just straight onto where I need it. I also want to make sure I do it completely central here. I mean, that looks pretty lined up, right? Maybe we'll go a little bit more to the right, if I can even do that. Yeah, maybe we'll try it like this and give it another go. It's annoying that I didn't get launched as well, because I didn't get to see where the crystal landed to know how to adjust it. Luckily, this puzzle's fun. Because otherwise it'd be annoying having to keep repeating it. Oh, this looks good. Okay, oh no, crystal stay. Oh, okay, we got it, guys, we got it. Let's plonk this in. This is going to be another Raru's Blessing one where I just get a reward. But I did have to put a lot of work into to get it to this point. Okay, now I just need to decide, can I be bothered to work out how to get that chest? I just need to know whether there is an opening on the underneath. Maybe I could go and have a look down here. I might be lazy and just mark it on my map and leave it for now. Because I really want to focus on getting that labyrinth done today. And I am getting a little bit distracted with all of these other things. Oh, so yeah, I'll have a little look down here. Because even if there was that opening, I guess I would just need to fly through it. Oh, let's give it a look. There's a track here anyway. Let's give it a shot. Do I have a ultra auto build flying device with an actual proper steering stick? Oh, this is just history. Because that's what I would like. I like a proper flying one. I don't, but tell what, let's just do this. And then I'll add a steering stick onto it. And then that way, if there is an opening on the underneath, I should be okay to glide through. And yeah, I got loads of steering sticks anyway. I can't believe how long I went in this game not having a steering stick. And then now that's, like, probably, like, one of the most common things that I have. But they're always, yeah, I just must have been so unlucky with all of the places that I went to for not getting any. Right, so this is going to take a little bit of fancy flying. I might fly, like, further away from it. Do a proper, like, pilot's entrance. And then I can get a big, wide loop. And oh, it doesn't actually look like there's an opening on the underneath of it. Okay, there's got to be something else that I need to do, which I can't be bothered to work out now. So I'll do a little mark on there that there's a treasure chest that I need to get. And then I could maybe now go and try and head to these islands. Do you reckon they're going to be reachable? I mean, they're a nice, like, little stop-off to make on my journey before I go and head to that labyrinth. I don't think I could reach that top one because I've only got one fan. And yeah, I can really only just about keep up going forward. But maybe from that... Oh, that one does actually look like it's got a capsule device. I just don't know if my glider is going to last long enough. I think it might end up disappearing. And oh, There's another shrine thing on that one there, actually. Oh, do you reckon it's the same again? Do you reckon there's a crystal up in that top thing up there? Maybe, right? I don't know! Oh, we're not going to make it. Oh, that's so frustrating. There's not really anything I can do here, right? I'm just kind of like, a little bit stuck. Actually, I wonder, look, if I do a platform, a hoverstone here. Oh, I can't see what I'm doing, so that thing's, okay, now I'm here. I wonder if I could auto-build on this platform? Maybe like one of these hot air balloons. I just don't know if my platform's big enough. Oh, it's gonna build. But then I'm gonna need to grab it. No, recall. Can I reach it? Oh, was that it there? Oh, yeah, there we go. So that's just the fan, but that will make the whole thing move. And then now I can grab it. Okay, so I need it to be on this. Oh, I can attach it to the platform. And then I get on it. And then if I now shake off the platform. Now we should be able to go. Oh, there we go. Oh, this is working. Oh, yeah, this is working perfectly. I kind of can't believe that worked, but it did work. I am starting to run out of energy, but I think I should be okay because I can just glide down. Because I want to get to that, the bottom shrine bit first anyway, because that's going to tell me where the crystal is and also going to make a teleportation point. I can't believe that worked. That was amazing. I'm a genius. I'm an absolute genius. Right then. Is this going to be pointing to that next big, that big sphere up in the sky above this one? Because you know what? If I make it up to there, that would be a good way to then get to that labyrinth. Right, it's definitely pointing up. Yeah. So, oh no! Not to this. It's pointing to like the bit next to where the big sphere was. But there was a another capsule dispenser here. Let's go check that out and see what goodies we can get from there. We can get some Zonai charges, which I can use to put in. Is this a thing? Ah, there's a big cube. I wonder if that's going to in any way prove to be useful. Oh, beautiful views up here as well. Let's have a little look at the landscape. I like this. This is what I thought. You see all these sky islands? Because this is all from the Water Temple. I thought this is what the game was going to be more like. I thought the game was going to be way more about all of these sky islands. But it's really not. It's still mainly about the ground. And then obviously there's the bits in the depths as well. Like, I thought the Sky Islands was going to be like the big main thing. But it seems like it isn't. Oh, lots of bombs. And then we've got the homing thingies, the homing carts. They're quite good. Is that everything? It is. Okay. This is a, when I did the hoverstone, that's like a C tier one, I think. Maybe a B tier on a good day. Not too bad. Right, is there anything else around here? There's some sundialions. It's always worth grabbing these when you're up here because there's obviously not many of them down on the ground, only the bits that have fallen down. Right, so I need to make it up to that. And so there's a launchy device here. Is it even launching? Does it need like, oh, it might need like weight in order to be launched? And then there's that area up there. I wonder if I'm going to have to use a bunch of these launch pads in order to make it up. So what's the deal with this cube? Oh, maybe if I launch the cube, I could recall it and then fly up with it. Let's just see whether this cube does set this thing off. No. It's got to be something to do with this. So what's this? Why isn't this one working? Does it need two cubes on it? Is it like a weighted thing? Because normally these are just kind of going on like a cycle. Let's attach this cube on. Is it like... Oh, wait. Do I need to press this button here? Ah. Maybe I need to press that to activate it. Well, let's take these off for now. I swear I don't normally need to press these buttons. And this is going to be like another like separate unique challenge. I promise you, we will get back to the labyrinths at some point. I'm just too curious with everything on the way. Ah, okay, yes. Something to do with that. Is that going to... Okay, now it's going. Oh, it's going like really fast as well. Let's put on my glidey clothes in case they end up proving to be useful. Oh, Sky Mine. Okay. So I'm guessing I could use this to launch myself up to that next one, and I don't need to build a flying device. So that seems kind of lined up okay. So yeah, I don't think I'll need the cubes. Maybe that was just to like test the flight, but this should launch me up to the next one. It's much steeper than they normally are. Like normally they're a much like lighter angle than that one was. And hello, buddy. Do you know what I wish I could do? I wish I could attach him to the rocket and then just use that to launch him off. Would be really funny. Right. Is there any other goodies around here? No, it doesn't seem like there's anything good. So is this one launching? It is. So the next island is over this way. This is a fun way to make myself get up to the top. So this looks pretty much lined up enough. If it's not perfect, it seems it launches me high enough that I'd be able to glide like down to where I need to go anyway. Yes, it launches me way above it. You know what? I might just ignore these guys and assume that I could just glide to the next one anyway. This might be a bad idea, but I'm gonna go bold and say that I could probably fly to wherever I need to go anyway. Should we go into this cube, the sphere, sorry, not the cube, first? And then, because it looks like on the way out, we could go and get to that crystal. I'm just curious to see what's gonna be inside of this sphere. Oh, wait. Is this like a weighted thing? Am I meant to get those big cubes up to here? And once again, there's a chest underneath that I don't know how to get to. Right, I think that's what I need to do then. I think I need to bring some of those cubes up to here and then to weigh that down in order to set it off. And it looks like there's cubes right down there on that one. Right, let's do that first and then we can do the crystal afterwards. So tell you what, let's actually just take out these enemies so they're not bothering me the whole time we're here. Hey, buddy. I might, if I got any spaces. Yeah, let's just put like a bunch of rockets because this feels like an area where having a bunch of rocket shields will be useful. I'm going to forget and just try and use one of these as like a normal shield, and then that's going to end up not ending up very well for me. Right, so I guess I need to shoot these through the hole in that sphere. So where's the shooty thing? Okay, so that's there. And then the sphere is there. Do you reckon that's gonna reach it? God, it's quite a long range shot, right? I mean, this would be impressive if I get a hole in one. Right, they've definitely given me loads of cubes here. Oh, it's a bit wonky. Okay, let's wait for it to go, and then we'll have plenty of time to get this lined up nicely. Oh dear! I didn't think it was gonna launch up that high. Right, let's hold it to the side. Okay, put it down nice and snug. Is that gonna make it in? God, I barely missed that thing there. Oh, it's looking good. Oh, hole in one! Right, let's do another one. Just in case that was not enough to weigh it down. And I need to. All right, that should make its way in as well. It was lined up pretty much the same. And yep, that went straight. That was satisfying. And look, and it should basically just launch me straight in as well, right? Oh, not quite. Not quite. God, imagine if they landed on the actual button. That would have been so satisfying. Sadly not, though. Right, let's put that there. And now the whole thing has spun. Oh, and it's still spinning. Okay. I wonder, is there going to be a gap where I'll be able to get through? No, because that's on that layer. And that cube's still there. Right, where's the opening? Oh, I can't even see where... Oh, is it out on the top now? I don't even see how I'd get out of here. I mean, I'm assuming this spinning is going to enable me to get down underneath. Do I need to ascend? I don't know if I could even ascend out of here. I'm just stuck in like a big spinning sphere. And I can't see where the opening is. I mean, maybe if I climbed up this, would I be able to ascend out the roof? I can. Okay, so that's how I get out. But I'm assuming I now need to get back in, but on the underneath somewhere. So maybe if I fly down to this island where the crystal is, I'll get a little look and if I could see where the hole is on the underneath. But then I do have to work out how to get in. Maybe back from that launchy pad would be the best way. Aha, yeah, look, there's the opening there. Oh, but it's not going to be the easiest thing in the world to get into. There's got to be a good reward in there. Right, yeah, let's try launching from here again. And then this time just trying to glide my way in. Make sure I have gust just to give myself that little horizontal boost at the end. Oh, this is perfect timing, actually. Right, so he's going to launch me way up here. Then I need to go around to the side. Oh, I'll tell you what, it's going to do another rotation. So let's go around this way. Then I should be pretty lined up by the time that opening comes back round. Well, where is it? Where is it? Oh, there's the opening. There's the opening. Go, 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 go. Yes! Ah, that feels... I feel so smart today. I mean, there's probably a smarter way I could have done that. Ooh, Zonite Shin Guards. Shin Guards, forged of Zonite, wearing them awakens the magic in their creators, improving efficiency for Zonite devices. That's good. So I guess that pairs with the mask. Ooh, you know what? I really wish that I got the chest in that other sphere. I will have to go back to get that if that's going to give me more Zonite stuff, because that would be really helpful. Anyway, we still haven't done the actual main shrine chest quest here. I still need to go grab that crystal from here. And go and bring it down. I might be able to just drop it straight off the edge there. And then I can just watch to make sure it doesn't, like, bounce off. But let's go gather up all of the loot on this island first. Okay, I grabbed up all of the ores and stuff. Right, let's see. Oh, see, it's hard to look down when I'm doing Ultra Hand. I guess I can see where the lasers... Okay, no, let's have a look. I need to have a proper look before I just drop this valuable thing off the edge. So, yeah, is that the one that I'm trying to get it to? Or is it further down? Oh, so, yeah, oh, yeah, no, that is the one, right? The shrine thing should be... Is it at the end down there? No? I swear I could see... Ah, yeah, there's the capsule. Yeah, it is. Look, it's right there. It's right there. It's right there. Okay, so I should be able just to drop this off here. And then... Oh, it's going, it's going, it's going, it's going. Is it going to stay there? Oh, yes, it stayed there. Oh, that is amazing. Then I can just glide down here. And then pop it straight in. Okay, so... Getting up to the top wasn't the easiest thing, but getting back down was. You know what? This has been my favourite... little combo of Sky Islands. I had been, as I kind of alluded to a little bit earlier, not disappointed with the Sky Islands, but like, I thought there'd be more to them, and I thought they'd be more varied. Like, a lot of them, it is kind of the same sort of things you do on them. But this has been like a fun little unique challenge that I've enjoyed doing. So right, I'm going to go into here, I'll grab the next Light of Blessing, and then I guess I'll just make a flying vehicle that will hopefully be able to fly me all the way from here over to the Labyrinth. Fingers crossed. Okay, so I've gone back up to the top island, and then I might just make this fan plane. Because I'm higher up than it, and if I use three fans, hopefully this glider will last long enough for me to reach over there. But if I just try and go as high as I can, even if it doesn't, hopefully I'll then just be able to glide down the rest of the way. Let's put my new stuff on though, shall we? So, this is the mask. Oh, it's from a different set, actually. Yeah, look, it's from this set. Because I'm organized. Wait, am I organized? Oh, no, I'm not organizing them by set. No, okay, I think they are from the same set. Okay, yeah, they are from the same set. Of course they are. They look exactly the same. I just need the middle bit. I'm just missing the chest piece or whatever. But I reckon that might be in that other chest, in that orb that I missed from before. So I will definitely go back and look at that for one day. But I really want to get this labyrinth done today. And we are beginning to run out of time. So, right, if I just glide over here... and try and stay as high as I can, then if this plane ends up disappearing or I run out of energy cells, which I shouldn't with my fancy new armor blowing in the wind, yeah, I should just be able to glide down and make my way there. Yeah, this should work. Right, the plane is beginning to disappear, but we are definitely close enough. So I might as well ride the plane just because it'll be quicker, just to make the most of it. But then when it does inevitably disappear, just... like this, I can then go and glide the rest of the way. And it looks like there's a shrine right out in the opening. That's probably going to be a proper shrine to do as well there. But I think it's probably mainly so I could teleport back up here. But the reason why that is dandy is because I do already have three Light of Blessings. So this is going to be ready for another upgrade. My health has just skyrocketed recently through the last few episodes. I've just been doing shrines left, right, and center. And oh, it's another slow-mo, low-gravity place. These places are always fun. So yeah, my guess is that this is going to be like an actual proper shrine and not just a Raru's Blessing. Because I think that's what it was on the other labyrinth I went to. But I may be about to eat my words. Nope! I am right. It is. Courage to jump. Oh, and this is a slow-mo shrine as well. And there's a bunch of lava. Wait, is that lava? Oh, it really looks like that lava's like floating. And then there's like a gap between it. Can you kind of see that? Like optical illusion? It looks like it's like a 2D plane of lava. But it's not. It's not. Right, courage to jump. I have courage. Look. Whoa! You know, I might put, just in case, the old flame guard armor on, just for this, right? Just in case things don't go to plan and my courage ends up backfiring. Right, so I guess because the slow-mo, I could make it over here because I have the courage to jump. And oh, just about. I didn't angle it very well. And that can get me over the lava. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, no, turn, 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 turn. No! Okay. I have courage to jump, but not ability to steer, apparently. Okay, I know what this is now. I know what this is. This is cool. It's going to be like a proper like driving shrine. It's going to be driving you crazy with how bad I am at it. So, right, I need to make sure I angle it. So I'm aiming far to the right. But then as I land... Oh, wait! I can turn... How can I turn midair? Did you see that? Because this isn't fans. This is just wheel. It just like defies physics and allows me to turn midair. I mean, it's useful, but it's weird. Right, I'm going to ignore these guys and go around here. There's a bunch of lasers there, which I'm not sure what I'm meant to do with. Are they just going to destroy? Oh, no, okay, I'm fine, I'm fine. No! No, I shouldn't have got out. Wait, where's my car? Where's my car? Oh, can I reach it? Oh, not quite. Right, I could jump over these. I just panicked when I saw the lasers. No! Ooh! Right, there we go. I can get my car back. We can carry on our journey. Right, come on. Come over here, car. Come over here. I kind of want you turning the right way round. Are you the right way round? Nope, you are exactly the opposite of the right way round. Can't really see what I'm doing here because the camera's going a bit mad. There we go. Okay. We will carry on our journey. So it looks like I'm meant to go right, but there's a an explodey thing here. I might just be able to crash through this with my car, you know, would be quite cool. Oh, yes, I can. Oh, I've got to be careful, though. There is something shooting electricity at me from behind. Let's just go out and grab this chest then, shall we? And we got... Oh, no, I don't even want it. No, I don't even care if it's better. I don't even want it. Don't even have a go at me in the comments. I'm sure it's better, and it would change my gameplay experience if I got it, but I just can't be bothered to juggle my inventory. Right, let's get back in this car. I keep nearly just jumping off the edge. So I'm going to have to avoid this chest now. This is certainly no Mario Kart. If you think I'm struggling controlling this, I promise you it's not the easiest thing in the world. And oh, there's a bunch of rockets there, but I'm assuming I would be able to make it without them. Let's just try and get a big run up and just see if I can make it over that gap. Because with the low gravity, surely I'll make the gap. No, I won't. I'm not going to make it. I'm not going to make it. I changed my mind. I obviously need the rockets. See, I had too much courage to jump there. That's what the problem was. Too much courage. Right, let's grab these rockets and add a couple of these to the back. I'm sure I'm not going to need all four of them because the low gravity is going to send me absolutely flying anyway. So, right, let's go on here. And now I have the courage to jump. Well, actually, I only just about cleared it. And that's got us right to the end. Oh, man. Talk about S-clear capsules. That was an S-tier shrine, that was. It wasn't much of a puzzle. It was just a drivey challenge. But it was fun. It was fun. And that, as I said, is my fourth Light of Blessing. So I will be able to get a new heart container very soon. But for now, let's focus on these labyrinths. Okay, then. I guess pressing this is probably going to open up this doorway. So I guess I kind of unlocked the ability to open this. Right, who's that? I offer a test of wisdom. All four terminals are hidden in this maze. Activate them all. Okay, this is basically exactly the same as the last one of these I did. So I should know what I'm doing. And last time, the last one I did, the terminals were all nicely marked on the map for me. So it wasn't too challenging. Let's go put back on my glidey clothes for now, though, I think, for this one. In case I'm going to end up needing them. And then let's put on my glowy trousers just because, well, they're glowy trousers. What more do I need to say? So is this fan going to boost me up? It is. Okay, this is exactly the same. So the terminals... oh, wait, they were marked here. So it looks like there's one straight to my right might be the quickest one to get to. Okay, I seem to have found my first terminal. Yeah, so if you didn't see the last labyrinth one I did this, it's like exactly the same. It's just like wind blowing up from underneath, and sometimes I need to put my parasailer down to fly underneath something. It's pretty simple, and it's going to be a lot of me just flying around these corridors, so I hope you're, can I just, I want to just climb this. Why can't I just climb this? How do I get out of this bit then? It's not boosting me high enough to get out of here. Oh, maybe it's not going to be that simple. Is this going to boost me over? I mean, I could always, I could ascend through here. And then I can kind of just cheat this and just run over the top and get to the next of the terminals. So yeah, as I say, like, you might see, I'm probably going to cut, like, most of this out because it is just going to be a lot of me just kind of gliding around the area doing the same thing. So where's the next one? So there's one in that back right corner. So I can basically, because I've got the low gravity, just run and jump and skip over all of this to get to them. Oh, you know what? I'm glad I came up here because there's a very... sneaky Korok seed up here. Is this going to be one of the arrow challenges? Oh, wait, no, it wants me to... Oh, I'm meant to dive off? Right, we'll do that at another time because I do not want to have to come all the way back here. So let's just mark that with a leaf. And then the next terminal... oh, why is the map so small there? But yeah, it should be right in this corner here. Let's just go drop down. Oh, yeah, there we go. It's right there. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to basically skip it all by just going on the top of them. It makes it much easier. Okay, here is terminal number 3. Found with no problems. And then, yeah, I just need to find another place. Ah, I think here I can do it. Yeah, I just need another place to ascend up to the top. And then I can just go and jump over the top. I mean, it does kind of feel like cheating, but it's like, I'm just using the tools they gave me. I mean, surely they'd, like, considered that this is just something that people could do, right? I mean, like, I'm sure they're not taken off guard by this. So, yeah, the one I haven't done is the one in that back corner. So now I just need to run and jump in slow-mo over to it to get the final terminal. And here it is. Right, I'm probably after this gonna need to make my way to the middle again. Then I'm assuming that from there I'm gonna be diving all the way down to the depths, which will be another labyrinth down there. And last time that labyrinth, I think I just got really lucky, but I seemed to like just find my way to it straight away for the end. And like, oh yeah, I got some armor. Didn't I got some like evil armor. Ah, I wonder if this is going to give me another piece. There was like evil like owl armor, if I can remember, which I have. I've suddenly got a little extra burst of enthusiasm for this puzzle because I've just kind of really thought about what it is I'm going to get at the end of it. Right, this should be the final one we need to do here. And then I think it's like the bottom one's meant to be like a combat puzzle. You who have traversed this maze, mark my words. I have pulled apart the bars in the labyrinth of the land that obstructed your path to the below ground. From high above to far below, prove your courage by diving into the depths of the earth. The final way shall open to you. Right, let's see if I can dive the whole way down. Right, no brakes. pedal to the metal. Right, this is just the ground level. This is that next labyrinth on the ground. We haven't even begun going down to the depths. There was probably some hidden loot, probably a big battery, knowing Nintendo, somewhere around there. Right, okay, well, we've got to break. I can't see where the ground is at all. And I'm wearing glowy stuff as well. Right, let's put more glowy stuff on. Okay, we pretty much stopped right at the last moment we could, to be fair. But you know what, it's very, very dark down here. Yes, as I said last time, I think I got really lucky. So I kind of went right to the end of this thing straight away. Unless it is just meant to be like one final combat puzzle. Yeah, maybe it is. Right, let's throw down a giant bright bloom shield seed. And then let's go against this guy then, shall we? Let's start this fight off. Oh, it is a level 3 one. Oh, I can get the thing straight away here, actually. Go shake. Okay, good, and it landed right by me. Let's get a big charge up. Come on, buddies. Help me out. Do some damage. Oh, my spear broke. That is okay. Let's use this instead then, shall we? It's kind of ironic that we're using one of the flux things to go up against it. Right, what's it going to do next? Oh, I quite like this one. Because if I can ascend through it, I can just get another. Oh, why can't I ascend? Oh, I can ascend. Right, go. Hopefully the ceiling's not too low. That's my only worry. Okay, no, we're okay. Because then I should actually be able to just finish it off if I get some good spins. Well, I keep hitting the other block randomly as well, but that's okay. It's just breaking my weapon a bit. Oh, no! It's badly damaged already. That got damaged real quickly. Right, let's just yeet it at this. Then let's just go and grab anything else for now. Let's just go and use this and try and get those final few hits we need. And it is done! It is done! And I could use this, the strong Zonite longsword, and I could attach the thing that it drops to it, and that should make a pretty spicy weapon, I hope. All right, let's grab all of the stuff. Contrast head. Okay, got some okay stuff. Not bad at all. Then let's fuse that to this. And, 47, as I said. Pretty spicy. Right then, let's go and press this final button, and that should give me another piece of that evil armor. Fingers crossed. You who have traversed this labyrinth of the depths. This trial was a test of your talents. In overcoming it, you have shown yourself strong of body, skill, and mind. In my name as the ruler of dragons, I commend your achievement and offer a fitting reward. Armor reefed in otherworldly evil, hidden away since days of old. Take it now. Yep, it's going to be the next piece of evil armor. And you know what? I know where the next labyrinth is. So if I do want to complete this set, I think I know exactly where it is that I need to go in order to do it. But let's check out what we get first. Evil spirit armor. And oh, this is the main one. Oh, it looks cool, doesn't it? It looks cool. Some believe this armor is inspired by a malevolent entity. It's a rather rare find. Let's go put it on then. Oh, man, it makes it look like Link's got a six-pack. Oh, and look at the cloak. It's got a cloak. I need to upgrade it. See, if you could wear, like, stealthy armor, why would you wear this when you could wear this? I definitely want to go and upgrade it, and then I'll be able to start using it properly in the future. Right then. Loads done today. We ended up running a little bit long compared to how long I meant to record for. I always get stressed doing recordings that are too long because I'm always just so scared my computer's going to crash or my program's going to crash and I'm going to lose it all. So that's like my limit for how long I record for. It's either until I lose my voice or I get too panicky that I'm going to lose the footage, which has happened before. So it's not like a... It's not like there's no truth to it. But I think this is a good point to end. All I'm going to do is see if there's a light route around here. Oh, wait, there's another chest. Another little chest. Hold on to your horses. We have a soldier blade. Oh, it is very... Oh, that's very good, actually. If I attach something good to that... And oh, wait a minute. These are what I found before. I found one of these, but I couldn't open it. That's because there's a whole labyrinth down underneath it. I don't think... Yeah, this isn't the one I found before, because I've not been to this area. But tell you what, let's fill in this bit and then I'll have a look on where I am on the map. Because this actually might be a good spot for me to venture off from in order to get some of the X's. Oh, actually, it might be all sealed off, actually. Oh, yeah, no, it's all kind of split off into a cave. Okay, I guess it's just like a one-off area. Yeah, and it is a little bit far away from these X's anyway. I'm sure there's a chasm I could go down to get them. Anyway, I'm blabbering on and on. I got things to do. You got things to do. Let's all get out of here, shall we? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!